Today's show will meet Professor Isaac Newton, positive and negative, and singing star Tiki. We are also going to take you to the classroom of Professor Von Drake. We also have a pie-eating contest. We're going to show you some behind the scenes of the movie Gully of the Chicks. And Ricky has promised to stop by and give us a song. Our special guest tonight is the Rolling Stones.
Direct from the little studio on 4th Street, it's the New York Variety Show. And now look sharp, here's the dear boy himself, Smiling Jack.
We're going to get rid of you right away before I even tell these jokes from the audience. These are the show me jokes. Now, I'll give you an example of our audience taste. Show me a man ironing a four-leaf clover, and I'll show you a man pressing his luck.
Boom!
Boom! Boom! Boom!
The audience
is
awake
today.
What do
you think that?
All right, here we go. Show me a guy with a top hat and tails on a trampoline, and I'll show you a Jim Dandy.
Oh!
That's right, a Jim Dandy! Yeah, Jim Dandy!
Make me a jokes!
Show me a fryer eating potato chips, and I'll show you a chipmunk.
Oh,
oh, let's hear it. Come on, enough of these here. Show me jokes. I'll give you some of my own. You know, years ago, they used to have a penny arcades, and they used to have shorties. Today, they don't even wear those.
Try the show me jokes, they were better.
And you know that Mickey Rooney, the guy's 48 years old, and with his shortness, he still gets in for half price.
How much do they charge?
Next, we're going to have the honky tonk men singing the honky tonk woman.
Oh!
my great announcer, James Glynn. Let's have a hand for James Glynn.
Thank you, Jackson.
How are you, James?
Okay. Hey, Jackson. We got a very important letter from somebody, a husband, who's having some trouble with his wife.
All right.
Now he writes, "Dear Jack, our 20th anniversary is coming up soon. The gift is China.
Uh-huh.
I don't like my wife very much. What do you suggest? Signed, Henpecked."
Dear Henpecked, how about a one-way ticket?
Very interesting. Now, Jackson, I heard that you were supposed to be one of the greatest pie and cake eaters around, right?
Yeah.
So I've decided tonight on our first show that I would challenge you to a pie-eating contest.
You think you can do it, folks?
I think so.
So, all right, so let's
just sit down here and we'll have some music and we'll start the contest.
Yes.
Now, when
we have some music, please?
When the music starts, we will begin eating.
Now, let me get my garb on here so I don't get my other garb wet.
Whoa, the music is
today we have our roaming cameras out again to nestle on Sir Isaac Newton. Take us to Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton, I understand you just discovered the forces of gravity. Would you mind explaining it to us?
Why, sure, Sonny. One day, I was taking a nap under the big old apple tree on Main Street, and a strong wind came and hurled an apple off, and it hit me on the head.
It looks like
after
that.
I studied the situation for a while, I made a discovery of what goes up must come down.
That's very interesting, Mr. Newton. But tell me, what's that you've been eating all through the interview?
Oh, this is my favorite food. Guess what they named it after me? A Fig Newton.
Thank you, Sir Isaac Newton. Next one, that field. Positive and negative. See, let's spend the night together.
Don't you worry about what's on your mind, woman.
You say it's your birthday. It's my birthday too, yeah. You say it's your birthday. We're gonna have a good time. I'm glad it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. Yes, we're going to a party. Yes, we're going to a party. Yes, we're going to a party. I would like to take you to a party. I said the wrong word. I would like you to dance birthday. Take a chance birthday. Would you like to dance? You say it's your birthday. It's my birthday too, yeah. You say it's your birthday. We're gonna have a good time. I'm glad it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, Positive and Negative, for that song, and our spy, Asparo, for his spy work and his birthday. Next, we're going to have Ricky right after this commercial with a song.
our first home-cooked meal.
I never seen a dumpling that big, sweetheart.
Well, I considered in making a lot of small ones, but I wanted to impress you. I wanted something that would really stick to your ribs.
It's just about where it stuck.
What's that, dear?
I said it was a shame you had to throw them out.
I didn't. I froze them.
Oh, God.
Let's see what's on tomorrow's menu. Marshmallow meatballs. Yum. Marinated herring. Yum. Is it beginning to rain, dear?
No. The stars are out. Beautiful night.
Chocolate-covered snails. Pouched oysters.
What love doesn't conquer, Alka-Seltzer will.
Introducing someone who makes less personal appearances than the Beatles. Here's Ricky. Doing it. Hey! Let's have a hand for him.
Less personal appearances, but mostly.
Well, baby used to stay out all night long.
Second half of the New York Variety Show in just a moment. This is WBCF, Channel 19 in New York City. welcome back to the second half of the New York Variety Show.
Detective, my husband is missing.
Give me a description.
He's tall, dark, handsome, weighs around 145 pounds, and he's very well dressed.
Wait a minute, that's not your husband. Your husband is short, fat, ugly, bald, and he weighs 250 pounds.
Shut up, I know, but who wants him back?
Hello, and welcome back. Each week we're going to take you to a scene from one of the new movies that are opening up. Tonight, we're going to take you to a scene from The Gully of the Chicks. All right, here comes the scene now.
Everybody thinks I'm beautiful, but everyone judges me from the outside. Nobody's really seen the inner me.
Oh, I've seen your x-rays. The inside of you is beautiful, too. I'm gonna leave this city of crime, lust, and sin.
Where are you going?
Back to my old damp paint place.
I'm gonna end it all. I'm going down to the drugstore to get some pills.
Why are you down there? Will you get me a bottle of Tabasco?
I was driving in my Cadillac and I hit the Queen Mary, which was right next to his Cadillac, which was also parked next to the hydrant, which was in my living room. Which under the bed, there was this here ocean liner, which I don't know how it got there. And my mother was dusting along, and she hit the pilot and knocked him off the boat. Enough of this, next we're going to have Tiki doing Navy. We are going to see what you have to say on the realm of talking about nothing. Very well, as you know, nothing is a state of mind by which there is absolute infinity. Which, hey, you put that bubble down when I'm talking about infinity and the state of mind which does not exist. Hey, students. Student over there! Get the chalk out of that girl's ear, or she will not be able to understand what I am telling her. Well, now, like I was saying about infinity, it does not exist, as we all know. Now, you are going to get to the moon with that balloon in 5 minutes. One. Hey, eyeglass just fell. Yes, students in the first row, first seat.
Professor, could you tell me something about the birds and the bees? Yes, tell us, Professor.
Well, if you don't know about the birds and the bees by now, you are in sad trouble. So, I will be happy to tell you about the birds and the bees.
And the storks.
The storks is another story we'll talk about a lot later. Now, the birds are insects which goes bzz, bzz, bzz. One which goes from flower to flower. One collects the lily pollen which makes flowers grow nice. On the other hand, the birds go tweet, 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 and they fly from tree to tree, which is an entirely different story from the little TV.
But Professor...
Now we talk about infinity. Yes, students in the back row, you have a question.
Professor, tell us the real way about the birds and the bees.
That is the real way without looking at the book, my room.
How do you make a baby?
How do you make a baby? You don't make a baby. You have one.
No, but how, Professor?
The stork brings it. Why do you think
how? The stork doesn't bring it. You know there's no such thing as a stork, Professor.
Yes, a stork. I have a pet stork at home. He
were
stands
you
like
by
this.
The stork, Professor? Did the stork deliver you?
Did the stork deliver
yes,
you what?
Did the stork deliver you?
Well, let me see. The milkman delivers the milk. The newspaper boy delivers the paper. And the professor deliverer delivers me. How do you like that? You don't like that?
No.
Yes. I always have to look out for the students in the back row. What specifically do you want to know, student?
Everything.
Student, get that chalk out of that girl's ear so I can tell her what I'm going to tell her. Better yet, put the chalk in the ear because I ain't going to say anything anyway. Student, you happy now?
No.
Yes. What do you want to know?
Well, I don't know. You're the professor. You're the one who knows everything. Are you
That's
married?
True. No, I am not married.
Got a girlfriend?
No, I have no girlfriend. They cost so much money, they are uneconomical.
Even no man would, no
students in the back, you're talking out of turn, put up your hand. You would put up your hand. Yes, your question?
I forgot.
Good. Student, you can take the chalk out now, I'm going to talk again. Student over there, the one in the transparent blouse. What do you mean you don't have no blouse on? Out of my classroom. Yes, student in the first row. The last question, because I only get paid by the hour, and the hour is up. Yes.
In the olden times, there was no stork, so how did Adam and Eve get Cain and Abel?
Well, Adam was lame, see? So he got this tree and he chopped out a cane, which he used to walk with. That's all we have for today, students. I will see you soon. Goodbye. I want to thank the professor. Now we all know about the birds and the bees. I want to thank everyone for the show, and I want to thank you all for watching the show, and I hope you enjoyed it. Good night.
Transportation for the New York Variety Show staff is provided by Barbara Zappoli. Production assistant, Laura Franzese. The New York Variety Show is a group WBCF television presentation. The following program was pre-recorded August 23rd with inserts of November 22nd.